So someone said in my last video that perhaps I should stop whittling hairs and start cutting some meat or other items to demonstrate sharpness. And I actually thought that that was a pretty good idea. Now, I got this demonstration from my friend Steve from Steve Kalari Custom Knives on Instagram. Highly recommend checking him out. He's on the forefront of custom kitchen knives. If you're thinking about a custom, he's the one to go to. He's a retired chef turned knife maker, and he's making some awesome stuff. He knows what he's doing. And here we go. Here's a sharp kitchen knife cutting stuff. Now, those of you who are familiar with my channel probably know where this is going and are currently sitting there laughing at the screen. And I'm kind of sitting here laughing too, editing this. It's kind of funny. Now, this knife really didn't have any problems cutting through a lot of the stuff that we were cutting here. And it would be sharp enough for 99% of the people who are actually using this knife. It's probably not going to be sharp enough for your professionals, but what if I told you that this knife wasn't even sharpened at all? What if I told you that there was zero apex on this knife? What if I told you that this knife was completely squared off? There was no secondary bevel on it whatsoever. It's actually a completely dull knife. Well, all of that is true. This is a completely dull knife with zero bevel on it whatsoever. It's just a straight up square edge. And it cuts through the vast majority of food items like this. So what in the world is going on here? How is it possible that a knife with no secondary bevel whatsoever and a completely squared off edge is able to cut relatively effortlessly? Well, to start, the knife I'm using isn't anything special. It's a $1 knife from the dollar store. It has, however, had some modifications. What I'm doing here is I'm doing something called thinning the primary bevel geometry and making the entire bevel thinner. That thinness is usually referred to as behind the edge thickness, and it's the measurement of the primary bevel right behind the secondary bevel. The thinner this is, the better the knife cuts. And in this case, and in the case of a lot of your high-end customs, thinness is actually what gives the impression of a knife being really sharp when in use, not the secondary bevel or the actual apex. So after a lot of slow grinding, thinning that primary bevel out super thin, we have this.
All right, we're about 6/7 thousandths behind the edge. So to put that into perspective here, I've got two pieces, count them, there's two pieces of regular old printer paper, but this is 6 thousandths, two sheets. And in case you're wondering, it doesn't really cut paper, but because the geometry is so thin, you can actually do that with it. And this is a completely squared off edge, no secondary bevel. Let me show you that.
Now, I actually forgot to measure the behind the edge thickness before I started grinding, but luckily I have another $1 knife that was similar in thickness.
So this one is looking to be about 35 thousandths.
So our knife is approximately 5 times thinner than when we started. I briefly showed this earlier and we are not even that close here. This is relatively not zoomed in super close, but this is the completely squared off edge. Maybe we have somewhat of a salt tooth going on that helps us a little bit in our cutting, but zero apex and zero secondary bevel.
So back to the original comment about cutting meat. The reality is that most food preparation tasks actually rely on primary geometry thickness for their cutting ability, not necessarily apex sharpness as demonstrated by whittling a hair. I personally know quite a few people who'd be perfectly happy using this exact knife right here with the completely squared off edge for their kitchen cutting tasks. It actually cuts really well for a knife that has zero apex on it. So cutting the vast majority of food items really isn't that hard if we're talking about primary bevel geometry. While secondary bevel apex sharpness is what is required for much harder things like plastics, wood, and hair, which actually has a hardness relatively close to copper. This is exactly why I don't do sharpness tests using food items, meat, vegetables, etc., because I'm testing a different type of sharpness, apex sharpness, not geometry sharpness. Now, we're just skimming the surface here when it comes to geometry, because at some point we can actually thin that primary bevel so thin that we actually do indeed form an apex, or the primary bevel becomes so thin that it cannot support itself doing the simplest cutting tasks and it'll just crumble under the stresses of simple cutting. So just like with anything else, there is a balance, but realize that primary geometry thickness and geometry in general is actually the most important thing when it comes to what makes a knife sharp. And it also plays a huge role, if not maybe the most important role, in edge retention. And I'll leave you with this. How long do you think a knife like this with zero apex retains its edge under normal kitchen use? Is there such a thing as edge retention for a completely squared off apex? Like I said, just scratching the surface.